Our NHL Update game tonight is Edmonton at Calgary, a good matchup for the opening of the smashing new Saddledome. Let's go there now live for a brief look at the opening ceremonies.
Calgary Olympic Coliseum Society. Five, the Saddledome Foundation. Six, the Olympic Organizing Committee.
Future. To the Olympics and beyond, we pay tribute to our homeland, our land of promise.
Of Canada, we sing with pride, our homeland strong and free. The crown of North America, a gem.
Grand night in Calgary as they celebrate the opening of the Saddledome. We'll be going back there throughout the evening for goals of the game between the Oilers and the Flames. Right now, let's go to Bob Cole with Gary Dornhofer.
In terms of housing its own Major League Hockey team, Calgary has been hoping for a big league first-class hockey facility at least since the mid-1970s. Tonight, of course, it's a reality. The National Hockey League's first ever game at the Saddledome is being played.
In the beginning, Calgary's quest for a Major League Hockey building started in 1975 when Jimmy Patterson transferred the Vancouver Blazers of the World Hockey Association to Cowtown and appropriately renamed the team the Cowboys. Joe Crozier's team was to provide the catalyst for the construction of a 15,000-seat arena at a cost of $20 million. But the league that provided Bobby Hull and the European Jets and the farewell tour of Gordie Howe couldn't make it here. And when the team failed to attract 3,000 season ticket holders to the tiny Stampede Corral, not only did talk of a new arena die, but the Cowboys themselves rode off into the sunset in the summer of 1977. The prospects for a new building lay dormant until the spring of 1980, when another Vancouver millionaire took another chance on Calgary as a big league hockey town. Nelson Skelbania shocked a lot of people when he bought the Atlanta Flames and moved the club to the Canadian Rockies without any assurance of a new building. But within 48 hours of announcing the move, Skelbania had received some 11,000 season ticket applications for the 6,500-seat Corral. The need for a big hockey rink was now real. Financing for the new building was made easier when a group from the Calgary Booster Club, headed by Frank King, became serious contenders to land the 1988 Olympic Winter Games. But no longer was the price tag in the $20 million range. Designs were being drawn up for a $60 million building. Adding the cost of land, the total figure rose to $83.4 million, and even that proved to be a conservative estimate. Construction of the unique building with a saddle-shaped roof began in the spring of 1981. Calgary, then in the last stages of a building boom. It was hard to get contractors, hard to get building supplies. But with the Flames coming off their most successful season and Frank King's team coming through with the Winter Olympics, there was great pressure to get the building finished quickly. The construction team decided on the fast track method. That meant construction started even before the design was complete, and that led to big trouble. First, the design team began making changes to the original plans. And when construction of the saddle-shaped roof became somewhat confusing, the completion date of December 1982 was delayed 10 months. But more important to Calgary taxpayers, rumors of a large cost overrun began to surface. The deficit was made public this summer. It was $16.5 million, bringing the total cost of Calgary's first big league arena to just short of the $100 million mark. The Olympic Saddledome became the talk of the summer. And while the cost overrun dominated the minds of the politicians and the media, the hockey fan didn't really care about the labor pains. He just wanted to see the baby. And this baby is something special. 16,700 seats with room for additional 3,000. A lavish restaurant. 33 box suites. And the list goes on and on.
Calgary's new Olympic Saddledome, a controversial landmark indeed. But opening night will long be remembered as the evening that Cowtown officially became a Major League Hockey city. I'm Gary Arthur for Hockey Night in Canada. It used to be fashionable to sit in box seats. Now the arenas of the 80s feature box suites. We'll look at our plays of the week as Hockey Night in Canada continues in just a moment.